Today we want to talk about why you'll never be happy just from losing weight. This is for you, just you. The point of today's message is to remind you that your existence is not ordinary. You're not a product of mass production. You're not a mass produced person. You've been customized by your own creator. Everything that you see in nature has been built by the hands of man, no matter how beautiful it looks. The only thing in the whole world that cannot be reproduced, copied or cloned is you. You are the product of the mighty hands of God Himself. He used His own hands to create you. You have differences, you have uniqueness, and you have peculiarities that are necessary for your life's purpose. You're not a copycat or carbon copy of any other creation. If I have to quote David the psalmist, you've been fearfully and wonderfully made. Just like David, I want you to look in the mirror and say, marvelous are your works. This is not to acknowledge your goodness, but to acknowledge God's goodness in you, to praise His marvelous creation, looking back in the mirror right now. What am I saying? I'm not trying to infect you with ignorance or arrogance, but attempting to encourage you to embrace your uniqueness. Why is that? Because you've lived all your life comparing yourself with everybody else. You want to be thin like so-and-so. You want to lose weight so that you can fit into that dress like so-and-so. Could it be that the reason you focus more on what the others have denies you and robs you of everything and enjoying what God has put in you? Could it be that there is you that you haven't met yet that is hidden deep inside you? Could it be that God wants to bring out so that you can meet the new you? I openly tell you that you'll never achieve your greatness until you learn to embrace your uniqueness. Those parts of you that keep on wishing that they look like someone else, your greatness is in your uniqueness. And a person that refuses to embrace your uniqueness is a person that will never experience their true greatness in life. Embracing one's uniqueness is what one needs to combat the biggest devil of our times, comparison. In our era, we compare everything. Who has the bigger house? Who has the bigger, faster car? Who has the most beautiful wife? Who has the richest husband? Who is thinner? Who has the latest cell phone? Who has more likes and friends on social media? Who has the cutest kids? Comparison is a calling killer. Comparison creates an appetite in someone else for something that God never intended you to have. If you've been customized by God Himself, then it means you've been built by design. Even if it is unrecognizable, even if it is uncultivated, God placed everything you need in you for what He created you to do. If you don't have it, it's because you don't need it, because your calling does not require it. Why do you covet what is in others and your calling in life is not the same as theirs? Whatever God demands from you, He provides. He'll never give you a calling and rob you of the tools to fulfill it. God never created anyone with a deficit. You come as a fully loaded, automatic, God's created design. The tendency to compare creates an appetite to covet. When you covet what others have, you become envious. Envy creates hate. And where there's hate, there's always death. When you are busy secretly coveting what someone else has, you're subliminally suggesting that God is wrong and saying that what God gave you is not enough. It's saying that if you had given me what you gave them, I could do and become who I'm supposed to be. How can we compare players that are not playing the same game? A rugby player has totally different skill sets than a boxer. You never see them wishing they had what the others has. You see everybody focusing on what they have, the skills they have, to compete in the sports and in the game that they were assigned in life. How can you compare yourself to someone that is not even playing your own position? Because your uniqueness is purely in the calling that you've been given. You don't need their weight because you are playing your position. You don't need their height because you are playing your position. There is a skill inside you that needs to be honed, that is suitable for the position that you've been called to play in this big game called life. If you just play your position to the best of the skills you've been given, you'll be surprised how good and how awesome you are. You might not do it like them, but believe me, when I tell you that there is nobody who can play like you, if you play your part and play it like you, you'll always come out the best version of you. You might not fight your Goliath wearing the king's armor, but if you use your sling and fight smooth, David, I can guarantee you, you will bring the giant in your life to his knees. If you embrace your unique skills, because your uniqueness is your secret sauce to your own personal success. We have to kill this thing that is killing our calling in life, this thing called comparison. In our society, the comparison has just become too much. We compare ourselves with each other economically, professionally, intellectually, and more physically. If you look at yourself and feel inferior because of what you saw in them, that is an unhealthy way of living. And if on the other side, if you look down on someone else and feel better about yourself because of what they lack, that is also unhealthy. If something must be wrong with me for you to feel good about yourself, then it means you're sick. There is something very wrong with that picture. Comparison is the bricks that build the brick house of envy. Envy is the core foundation of a thief. Envy's job is to steal from you, not your skills or your possessions, but to stop you the ability to enjoy them. Isn't it interesting when people are playing with you and you're not even playing the game? The only worthy competition is competing against yourself. Your job in this world is to be better than who you were yesterday. Comparison is a trap. It is a bottomless hole with no ladder to climb back up. To look at where someone else and wish you were in their shoes. Why compare yourself with others when you did not have their help, when you did not have their resources, when you did not have their information? It is illogical to think that you should have, could have, and must have been somebody else. How can you try to be a copy of somebody else and run away from the original you? Could it be God that God maybe saved the best for last? That's why you're still going through what you're going through. Could it be that God is going to give you your heart's desire, but not according to your clock, but according to his watch? Because God is supreme and he runs the show, and he will only do it when the time is right. Not for you, but to fulfill his purpose. I am encouraging you to embrace your uniqueness, because your uniqueness is the master key to your health and fulfilling your God-ordained divine purpose. My dear sister and my dear brother, could it be that God is trying to bring out the you that you've hidden from the world so that you can meet you? Underneath all your jokes, all your impatience, and all your impulsiveness, there is a you in you that looks like nothing that you have seen. Could it be that God is trying to call that out? Could it be that God wants the wiser you to come out? Could it be that God wants the stronger you to come out? Could it be that God is calling the more beautiful you to come out? Stop giving into this facade of limited potential and allow the resurrection of your higher self to come out. Just meet the new you. You have to learn to embrace her or embrace the new you. You've made some mistakes in the past, but this higher you is still in you. You've made some missteps, but you're still in there. You're not where you want to be in life, but the new you, the higher you, the God created you is still in there. You have insecurities. Yes, we all have them. But the good higher you is still in you. My personal prayer is for God to stop you until the best version of you comes out. I pray God not to give you peace until the you, the she or he, comes out of you. Stop settling for mediocrity when God has created you to live your best life in his image. Stop comparing and start embracing. You've been trying to lose weight all these years because you want to look like somebody else. But for the first time, embrace your uniqueness and let's get to where you're supposed to be, because the you will come out.
You've been trying to lose weight for as long as you can
remember. Your weight has become the Goliath in your life. The problem is that you've been trying to win this battle wearing Saul's armor rather than using your sling with five smooth stones as David did. Join the Dream Body Fitness Purpose Partners Program. Purpose is the original intent why a thing was created. And God created you, my friend, for a specific purpose. Forget diet. Forget exercise. And for the first time, place Jesus in the center of your weight loss. Let us lose weight for Jesus. Join the Dream Body Fitness Purpose Partners Program today.